Welcome back. You're still watching Buy Now, Sell Now. Time to focus on an individual stock, JK Lakshmi Cement. They delivered their numbers last evening. It's been a steady quarter, though, yes, offtake plunged. YOY, there's been a bit of a significant dip coming in. The volumes as well, down 18% year-on-year. Profits saw a steady expansion, though EBITDA was also down 14%. Let's touch base with the management. We have Mr. Shailendra Choksi, the whole-time director, join us right now on the show. Mr. Choksi, thank you so much for taking time out. There was robust strength internally seen in cement prices because of strong pricing, low input costs. Can you tell us if this is a sustainable trend going forward? What is your projection?
I think we are quite satisfied in terms of the results, because we had expected, when our plants had got under lockdown and the entire market was closed from 23rd March onwards, our own apprehension was that probably a month or two would be a total washdown, total washout. And it actually happened that April was practically a total washout from 23rd March to the end of April. And then gradually we started ramping our production facilities. The market also picked up from, started from the last week of April and picked up gradually by middle of May. So I think therefore in this situation to have reached with just a minus 18% sale figure compared to the corresponding quarter last year, we feel greatly satisfied that things worked well and that we could avail of the opportunities wherever we could find one in terms of our sale. We could still manage a decent number. So we clocked an 18% fall in our sale figure, which compares well with the industry, which has seen a degrowth of almost 32 to 34%. And the EBITDA numbers are also, because the realization remained more or less as it was in the previous quarter. So we could, and we could also contain some of our fixed costs, especially in these times. As a result, we could manage with an EBITDA fall of about 20-21%, which we had apprehended would be much more.
Can you give us some color on the volume offtake? What was the capacity utilization trends? And did offtake issues persist in this quarter as well?
Let me start with the last question first about the difficulties in the offtake. There were logistic constraints to reach the market. I think there was some pent-up demand, especially in the rural markets, because they were the first one to open. The urban market quite some time to open. The rural markets, there were logistic constraints. There was a lot of inventory which was lying on the road when the lockdown happened. So to take a control of all those trucks, then to get back the drivers, it was a huge challenge from the third week of April when we started mobilizing all these people, ensuring that the trucks which had our cement with them and lying on the road for about a month, that they reached the dumps or the nearest market. So initially we had a lot of challenges with respect to the logistics. Then there was a demand, a pent-up demand, because the lot of construction work got stopped in their tracks in the middle of nowhere. So they were wanting cement, but we had difficulty initially in the supply chain, which we overcame. And therefore from middle of May, we saw some traction and we could ensure that the whole of June, the demand was good. You could reach the cement to wherever it was needed. And that is how we could manage with just about 18% loss in our volumes, Q1Q.
Okay, sir. And what is the current capacity utilization trends? Also, is there any demand for products currently? Is it moving in any particular direction, especially since both the infra and realty projects have been at a standstill?
In terms of capacity utilization, if I were to go sequentially, April was practically almost about 15-14% capacity utilization. May onwards we picked up, and if I were to only see my the kiln working, May and June, and we could reach about 70-80% capacity utilization. So if I were to only see how I worked during the days that we operated, cumulatively, all our plants combined, we did very close to 90% of our capacity utilization in the days that we worked. But if I were to spread it over the entire period, it would be anywhere around 65% capacity utilization.
Can you tell us how the situation is in terms of recovery post-lockdown demand that you've seen witnessing after lockdown, and the rural demand, is that the one that's aiding recovery?
Actually, in terms of the demand forecast, things are still very hazy at the moment, very fluid and fairly uncertain. Because, you know, now we are finding that almost from 21st of July, our eastern operations getting very badly impacted due to the lockdown. So you have lockdown situation in Chhattisgarh, you have a lockdown situation in Odisha, in part. Most of these states are observing lockdown during the weekends, only 5 days working or 4 days working in some of the states. So right now it's fairly uncertain, but we are pinning hope. And then, of course, there's a monsoon impact in the second quarter.
Thanks, Mr. Choksi, for joining us with the Q1 update. The stock continues to trade low by 3.5%. We're wrapping it up right here on Buy Now, Sell Now. We'll start off with the MPC coverage. Stay tuned to ET Now.